Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Dragon Age Origins. I am Killswitch423, as you know, you're on my channel. Here in the Fade, about to go finish the Fade portion, actually. Yes.
Now's better than later.
It only took 2 hours. And that was with me pretty much knowing what to do already. Gosh, it took me way too long the first time. Save right here. Demon.
What do we have here? A rebellious minion? An escaped slave? My, but you do have some gall. But playtime is over. You all have to go back now.
Oh, here I am. And there you are. You just disappeared. Well, no matter.
You tried to keep us apart. You led us from each other because you fear us, don't you?
You will not hold us, demon. We found each other in this place, and you cannot stand against us.
Yeah.
If you go back quietly, I'll do better this time. I'll make you much happier.
I'm not doing anything you tell me.
I could make it like the real world, if that's what you want. I could keep you happy indefinitely. Do you want that?
I want to be free.
I made you happy and safe. I gave you peace. I did my best for you, and you say you want to leave? Can't you think about someone other than yourself? I'm hurt. So very, very hurt.
Sorry, but I'd rather just be rid of your evil right now.
You wish to battle me? So be it. You will.
I prefer the term slaughter, but yeah, sure, battle works. Alright, Mark of Death. You. Finally with my party again. Nice.
Make a preserver.
Stab, stab. Come on. There we go. Thank you. Ow. You're mean.
Let's end this.
Ow. Stop that. Ow. Alright, first form's almost done, I believe. Gotta fight through other forms of this guy. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
I'll get on it.
Alright, so Mark of Death. Some poison on.
I suppose violence is a solution. Sometimes.
Keep attacking, come on. You got this guy, come on.
Defend yourself! I'll get on it. Enough!
I'm gonna get you a ladder so you can get off my back.
Oh, you have my strength, you are.
You're gonna regret this!
Yes, come on.
Just run away over here.
Come on. Follow him. Why will you not do that? More poison. I will save. Wait, keep attacking.
Face me and die.
Keep attacking. Mark of death.
Now's better than later. I'll get on it.
Yes. Ha ha ha. We are victorious because we are awesome.
You defeated the demon. I never thought it. I never expected you to free yourself. To free us both. When you return, take the litany of Adrala from my body. It will protect you from the worst of the blood magic.
Aren't you coming to help?
I cannot go with you. I have been here far too long. For you, it will have been an afternoon's nap. Your body won't have wasted away in the real world while your spirit lays in the hands of the demon.
Think you're gonna die?
Every minute I was here, the sloth demon was feeding off of me, using my life to fuel the nightmares of this realm. There is so little of me left. I was never meant to save the circle or survive its troubles. I am dying. It is as simple as that.
I could heal you.
Thank you, but it is too late for me. I do not fear what may come. They say we return to the Maker in death, and that isn't such a terrible thing. My only regret is that I could not save the circle. But you... you can. Take the litany off my body when you return. It is important.
I will do this.
I'm not a hero. Perhaps trying to be one was foolish.
Yeah, that's not true. You did a lot.
Dark times, greater acts of heroism, eh? You may be right. Before I was taken to the circle, my mother said I was meant for greatness. I would be more than my ancestors could have ever dreamed. I hope I haven't disappointed her.
You didn't.
It is time for us both to be on our way. Remember the litany of Adrala. The circle is all that matters now. Thank you, and goodbye, friend.
That's unfortunate. Alright, yes, out of the Fade and saving. Oh, man.
Alright, alright. Litany.
Inventory full. Really? Let's do a shock bomb on here just so I can use it. Let's get rid of the nature salve. Take the litany, put it on my hotbar. Where'd it go? Where did it go? Where did it go? Where did it go? There it is. Litany of Adrala. Gonna go right there. Alright. Save that. Loot this corpse. If I can. Health poultices, that's nice.
Now's better than later.
Having it. Charred corpse.
All right, all right.
Libertarian's cowl. Ooh. Let's destroy that. Take off. Let's see when. Defense mana regen. Willpower, spell power, mental resistance. Kinda like the mana regen, to be honest.
Got it.
Right, yeah, that thing. Hey guys, what's up?
All right, all right.
Where is everyone? Why is no one following me? What? Oh. Got in the whole position somehow. Great. Yeah, let's just do the things.
Got it.
Potion, yes. She is much better. Oh man. That was the problem earlier. Chest? Oh man. Don't have room for any of this. Although, these are nice. Alfred's common enough. Three. Also, I forgot I have that. Use it. Doggy. Oh yeah, it's the better version of that. Good. Yeah, that's just nice. Okay, cool. Save. Forgot to bring Dougie back out.
I'll get on it.
Yeah. Sweet. Save. Useful on you. Ow. I hate that so much. Chests. Yeah, sounds good. What are you? Oh, all the resistances. Worth almost 2 gold. Start that, take that. Save. No, I don't want that. A vase. Open you up. Oh, wow. Beastman's dagger. Oh, that's so much better than what I'm using. Just take all. Okay. Templar's longsword. Oh, that's nice, too. Okay, shoot. regular level boots can go away. And the regular studded ones. Take these. Because that is a sweet dagger. We'll replace my second one. Yeah. Sweet. And Alistair. Templar's longsword. Not enough damage, but increased. Nope. The other one. I'd like the other one better. Saving again. More chests and corpses. Oh, hi. Nice. Now, what's this soldier corpse? A potion and some monies.
Can I get you a ladder so you can get off
another
my back?
Another one of those, okay. Save again. Ah, yes. Helen.
He's still alive, I think.
This trick again? I know what you are. It won't work. I will stay strong.
Are you all right?
The boy is exhausted. And this cage, I've never seen anything like it. Rest easy. Help is here.
Enough visions. If anything in you is human, kill me now and stop this game.
He's delirious. He's been tortured and has probably been denied food and water. I can tell. Here, I have a skin of...
Don't touch me. Stay away. Filthy blood mages. Getting in my head. I will not break. I'd rather die.
You're not gonna die if I can help it.
Silence! I'll not listen to anything you say. Now be gone! Still here. But that's always worked before. I close my eyes, but you are still here when I open them.
I'm real and I'm here to help you.
Don't blame me for being cautious. The voices, the image is so real. Did Gregor send you? How? How did you get here?
I'm a Grey Warden trying to help save the tower.
Good. Kill Aldred. Kill them all for what they've done. They caged us like animals. Looked for ways to break us. I'm the only one left. They turned some into monsters and... Oh, there was nothing I could do.
Aldred will pay for what he's done.
To think, I once felt pity for the Circle. Now I'd like nothing more than to wipe their taint off the face of Thedas.
Not all mages are evil.
Only mages have that much power at their fingertips. Only mages are so susceptible to the infernal whisperings of the demons.
This is a discussion for another time. Irving and the other mages who fought Aldred, where are they?
They are in the harrowing chamber. The sounds coming up from there. Omega.
We must hurry. They are in grave danger, I am sure of it.
You can't save them! You don't know what they've become.
And you do?
They've been surrounded by blood mages whose wicked fingers snake into your mind and corrupt your thoughts.
His hatred of mages is so intense. The memory of his friend's deaths is still fresh in his mind.
He suffered pain and anguish like few have had to endure. That and his lust for revenge have confused the issue.
Do not presume to judge me, mage. I am thinking clearly, for perhaps the first time in my life.
Your outrage says differently. I agree with Wynn.
Then you are a fool who does not see the heart of the situation. To ensure this horror is ended, to guarantee that no abominations or blood mages live, you must kill everyone up there.
I'd rather spare Maleficarum than risk harming innocent.
Thank you. I knew you would make a rational decision.
Rational? How is this rational? Do you understand the danger?
I know full well the dangers of magic, but killing innocents because they might be Maleficarum is not justice. I know you are angry.
You know nothing. I am thinking about the future of the Circle, of Ferelden.
Yeah, like these blood mages, I can take them.
You may be confident in your ability to stand up to them, but what about the rest of us? Will you protect us from them?
We don't know that they're all blood mages.
I am just willing to see the painful truth, which you are content to ignore. Ah, but what can I do? As you can see, I am in no position to directly influence your actions, though I would love to deal with the mages myself.
Good, then you can't cause any trouble.
My cage is Aldred's doing, or one of his mages. Once they're dead, I will be free.
And then I will also decide what to do with the others.
No one ever listens. Not until it's far too late. Maker turn his gaze on you. I hope your compassion hasn't doomed us all.
I completely understand his viewpoint right now, but with the trauma he just endured. Let's do this. Come on, Aldred. Aldred.
Do you accept the gift that I offer?
They knew better than to cross the streams. Hey, ugly.
Ah, look what we have here. An intruder. I bid you welcome. Care to join in our revels?
Stop what you're doing. I'll give you one warning. One warning.
Oh, how could I disobey when you say that in such a commanding voice? I'm quite impressed you're still alive. Unfortunately, that must mean you killed my servants. Oh, well, they are probably better off dying in the service of their betters than living with the terrible responsibility of independence.
I'm sorry, are you upset I killed your lackeys?
We needn't fixate on who killed whom. That doesn't help our relationship.
What are you trying to accomplish by torturing these people?
A mage is but the larval form of something greater. Your chantry...
Not my chantry, but
calls us
whatever.
Abominations when we have truly reached our full potential. Look at them. The chantry has them convinced. They deny themselves the pleasure of becoming something glorious.
You're mad. There's nothing glorious about what you've become, Aldred.
Aldred? He is gone. I am Aldred, and yet not Aldred. I am more than he was. I could give you this gift, Wynne. You and all the mages. It would be so much easier if you just accepted it. But some people can be so stubborn.
Say what you like, I'm still gonna kill you.
Resistance! Everywhere I go, resistance! How very inconsiderate! I even have the first enchanter on my side, don't I, Irving?
What have you done to him?
Stop him. He is building an army. He will destroy the Templars, and...
You're a sly little fox, Irving. Telling on me like that. And here I thought he was starting to turn.
Never!
That's enough out of you, Irving. He'll serve me eventually. As will you.
I'd rather die.
Killing you would be a waste. Your raw potential... with the strength of a demon behind it, would be unstoppable. I can do that. I can give you power and a new life.
Yeah, you die now.
Fight if you must. It will just make my victory all the sweeter.
I'm so itching to stick a dagger in his throat.
It will thwart Aldred's attempts to control the mages. And win this fight for us.
All right, you getting the mark of death on you.
Let's see what you're made of.
Okay, it's over.
Yay, level up. Haha, you're dead. Don't think you got any of them. Sweet, what you got on you, big guy?
Now's better than later.
Cinderfell gauntlets, fire damage and resistance, that is nice. I will have to take that, thank you.
I'll get on it.
Yeah. Sweet. That went... incredibly easily.
Oh, Maker, I'm too old for this.
Irving, are you all right?
I've been better, but I am thankful to be alive. I suppose that is your doing, isn't it, Wynne?
I wasn't alone. I had help.
The Circle owes both of you a debt we will never be able to repay. Come. The Templars await. We shall let them know that the tower is once again ours.
All right, lead on.
I'll need you to guide me down the stairs. Curse whoever insisted the Circle be housed in a tower.
Yes.
Irving? Maker's breath. I did not expect to see you alive.
It is over, Gregor. Aldred is dead.
Aldred tortured these mages, hoping to break their wills and turn them into abominations. We don't know how many of them have turned.
What? Don't be ridiculous.
Of course he'll say that. He might be a blood mage. Don't you know what they did? I won't let this happen again.
I am the Knight Commander here, not you.
I believe order has been restored.
We will rebuild. The circle will go on, and we will learn from this tragedy and be strengthened by it.
We have won back the tower. I will accept Irving's assurance that all is well.
But they may have demons within them, lying dormant, lying in wait.
Enough. I have already made my decision. Thank you. You have proven yourself a friend of both the Circle and the Templars.
It had to be done.
I promised you aid, but with the Circle restored, my duty is to watch the mages. They are free to help you, however. Speak to them.
You mean the first enchanter?
Yes, Irving. For now, I will have to oversee a sweep of the tower. There may be some survivors, and we should do our best to tend to them. Please excuse me. And Irving, it is good to have you back.
Ah, I'm sure we'll be at each other's throats again in no time.
Alright, save so we can level up here. Doop. Yes, coercion. Exploit weaknesses. Yeah. I like my passives. Save after that. Colin.
I'm glad I'm still alive, but the Circle's future still remains to be seen.
Irving.
Here we are, the tower in disarray, the Circle nearly annihilated. Oh, it could have been much, much worse. I am glad you arrived when you did. It's almost as though the Maker himself sent you.
I'm glad I could help.
From what Gregor said, it seems that you came here seeking allies. The least we can do is help you against the Darkspawn. I would hate to survive this, only to be overcome by the Blight.
So I have your word?
You have my word. As first enchanter, the Circle will join the Grey Wardens in the fight.
Irving, I have a request. I seek leave to follow the Grey Warden.
Win. We need you here. The Circle needs you.
I appreciate the sentiment, Irving. But the Circle will do fine without me. The Circle has you. This woman is brave and good, and capable of great things. If she will accept my help, I will help her accomplish her goals.
It's an honor.
You were never one to stay in the tower when there was adventure to be had elsewhere.
Why stay when I can be of service elsewhere?
Then I give you leave to follow the Grey Warden, but know that you will always have a place here. There is much to be done here, and I must go. You must forgive me for not being a proper host.
Can the Circle go to Redcliffe to save a possessed child?
The child is possessed, but killing the demon would mean killing the... Unless you intend to enter the Fade. Yes, it can be done with a group of mages. I shall gather what mages I can, and we shall leave promptly. A life is at stake.
Woohoo! Alright. Wynn is now our permanent party member. Save. Let's go sell things. you. Buy my stuff.
You really killed all those abominations? I didn't think it was possible. I thought we'd all die here. I'm sure you need supplies after that, don't you?
Yep, trade. Alright, keep that. Keep. Sell. Sell. I never remember to use them anyway. Keep. Sell, keep. Oh, yes, so good. Sell, keep. Sell, keep. Sell, all of them. Sell, all of them. Keep. Fade armored helmet. Oh, that's nice. Keep. Compare to Alistair. Sell. Compare to moi. Doesn't tell me how much it improves backstab, so. Zevan. Oh, yeah. Pizza, so. Oh, you know what? This all seems very good for Arcane Warrior. Fade Armored. I'll keep the Fade Armored stuff. Chainmail. Well. Mr. Heavy Infantry. So. Oh yeah, yep, that is, well, I mean, blood magic, but all the other stuff is still so good. Heavy plate? No. Shield of the Great Wardens. Archon robes, wind. So. So. Shiver. Oh, that would be good for Morrigan. Just maybe, you know, lore reasons. Sailor's Charm. Keep these and we go through them still. Get the rings, the runes. Gift. Yay, gifts. So. Keep. Okay. You don't have any backpack.
You really killed all those.
Yes.
I'm sure you need supplies after that, don't you?
Yeah, let's do that. Oh, darn it.
I'm sure you need supplies.
Do you have... Let me take a rune. Thorn. Oh, not bad. Spiral Fan. Drill's Blessing. Oh, wow. That's so good. So expensive, though. Nine commander gloves. Okay. Staff. Wow. Jeez. Oh, Tome of Arcane Technique. Remember that that's here. And I will head out. We will camp and then head on back to Redcliffe. to try and save Connor. All right. Conversations.
Your dog is filthy. I can smell him 50 yards off.
Good, he will fell our enemies with his stench.
That may be so, but all the same, I would like your permission to bathe him.
Go ahead.
Excellent. I will get my soaps, and the dog shall have his bath after supper.
Trying to find a way through the earth, are we? It's gonna take some time, you know. Yeah, good luck with that. Oh, your puppy. You have your puppy. Okay. Alistair.
Yes.
Questions?
Of course.
Never mind. Talking to Liliana for a bit. When?
Oh, it's been a long day. Rest. Rest would be welcome.
Are you alright?
Yes, yes, of course. I am just a little weary. As you may have noticed, I'm no spring chicken.
No, you're a Persian.
Very funny. But in all honesty, I do not know how many years I have left in me. I have lived for such a long time, but there is always something else to do. And I have to keep going in order to do it. I think I will be glad when I am done.
I'm sure he'll be kicking around for years yet.
Oh, I don't know. I really don't.
That's depressing. More dark.
Have you encountered many abominations, apart from the ones in the Circle Tower?
Well, there was Connor.
Ah, yes. Connor. Of course. The first time I saw an abomination, my blood turned to ice. It was months before the nightmares stopped. It was the knowledge that I could easily become one of them that frightened me the most.
Yeah, you're great. I wouldn't worry. You'll be fine.
Every mage is vulnerable, no matter how accomplished or powerful. That is the first thing we learn, and overconfidence can lead to recklessness. One slip. All it takes is one slip, and everything you are is simply gone, replaced by madness. And there is no turning back, or at least that's what they say.
You have doubts?
Of late, I have begun to wonder if there is any way an abomination can be cured, or if a mage could be so possessed and still retain their sanity, their humanity.
I'd argue that if they have their humanity, then they're not an abomination.
Yes. It is madness and cruelty that define abominations. If those are lacking, if the mage remembers the person they truly are, then they are not an abomination. I never saw that. Thank you for showing me another way of looking at it.
You're welcome. More talking.
So, tell me, how did you become a Grey Warden?
I was tainted, and only the joining could save me.
Then you became a Grey Warden out of necessity. But Duncan must also have seen something special in you. The Order does not take in recruits just to save their life. You must be proud to be able to represent your tribe and the Dalish as a Grey Warden.
Yeah, You know, a while ago she definitely would have gone with one. She's more confident than three, and not quite as bloodthirsty for four. And at this point, she really wouldn't rather have died, because she wouldn't have met all these people that she now considers friends, and her views in the world would have not have, you know, expanded as much as they have. She wouldn't have grown as much as a person. So I think at this point, she's looking back and really, she is thankful for what Duncan did.
Sometimes it gives me comfort to think that everything will end up the way it's supposed to. That it will be all right. You were chosen. You survived the joining when others did not. Perhaps it was meant to be.
Well, thank you. I like Gwyn.
I must ask, what does being a Grey Warden mean to you?
I've been chosen to do something important.
There's that, of course. But there's more to being a Grey Warden than killing Darkspawn and saving the world from the Blight. Ultimately, being a Grey Warden is about serving others. About serving all people, whether elves or dwarves or men.
You mean to say I serve as a protector? You know, she's kind of falling into that role at this point, and she has the ability and power to do so, so she is starting to like the feeling she gets when she helps, you know, goes out of her way to help people.
As a Grey Warden, you are a guardian of men, and you guard them because their continued existence is more important than you are. Thus, it is you who serves, not they.
Yeah, that makes sense.
A good king. A true king who cares for his land, uses his power to rule firmly but fairly. He serves his people first and foremost. The king who does not do this, who believes that he is entitled to his power, who abuses it and uses it for his own means, is a tyrant.
Yeah, I just don't really care for political power and leadership. Honestly.
If you live apart from others, and your actions affect only you, then you may do as you wish. But if you have power, influence, and strength, your every action will be as a drop of water in a clear, still pond. The drop causes ripples, and ripples spread. Think of how far they will go, how wide they will become, how will they affect the pond. But I've lectured enough for today. I should stop before I wear out my welcome.
More.
Is there something you
need?
Okay,
finally into these. Why didn't you want to stay at the tower?
The circle is in good hands. Irving knows what to do, and he doesn't need me underfoot. For now, I will support those that battle the Darkspawn. I do feel I left things unfinished in Ostagar. There is so much left to do. And I would be part of it.
I'm glad for your company.
The Grey Wardens, all two of you, need all the help you can get. I will see this through to the bitter end, and after that, if I am still left standing, then I will return to the Circle.
I wanted to make sure you really wanted this.
No, of course I don't. I'm old and unsure of what I'm doing. Actually, I'd rather be in a warm chair in the sun, being served pudding, or some other easily digestible food.
That didn't mean it that way.
I know. I was just teasing. The ability to laugh at myself is something I developed too late in life. But to allay your fears, yes, I am sure this is what I want.
More talkie.
Is there something you need?
I like talkie. We'll go ahead and ask what this is relevant.
This is for the Arl's son, the young abomination, yes? There is something that can be done, though it is not a simple matter to accomplish by any means. There is a connection between the child and the demon, one which can be followed to the demon's true form within the Fade. There the demon can be battled directly. The difficulty lies in entering the Fade. Only a mage can do so. But it requires a ritual that calls for both Lyrium and a group of mages. And we possess neither of those things, obviously. And even had we those things, there is no guarantee that a single mage, alone, could defeat the demon that controls the child.
But we're gonna do it anyway.
Is there something you need?
I
will answer to the best of my ability.
How'd you become a mage?
People don't become mages. They are born mages. The talent just surfaces later. But you are asking how I ended up at the Circle. I was brought there by the Templars, just like many of the other apprentices. I don't remember very much. I was very young then.
What about your family?
I didn't have a family. I never knew my real parents. My earliest memory was of hiding in a hayloft on a farm, trying to keep warm. I was found, and the farmer's wife was kind enough not to send me away. But they had children of their own, and I was never made to feel welcome. The eldest son was the worst. He was always calling me a stray, and throwing anything he could get his hands on at me. And I don't know how it happened, but one day, he just found his hair on fire. Fortunately, there was a large trough nearby.
Serves him right.
He ran screaming, dripping head and all, to his mother. I was shut up in the barn, with a bowl of water and a crust of hard bread. The Templars arrived several mornings later.
No bueno.
The barn kept me safe from the village children and the stones they would hurl at me. I was afraid, yes, but it could have been much worse. I'll never forget the moment the Templars led me into the entrance hall of the tower. I had never seen anything so grand in my life. I stopped being afraid then. I knew I was home.
That's a pretty good story, yeah.
Well, that's about all there is to my tale. That's how I came to the Circle.
What was it like there?
I would be lying if I said it was easy. First, there were rules, and we were constantly watched to make sure we behaved appropriately. Then there was the study of magic. We had to cast the spells just so, control the effects completely. A single word spoken incorrectly, a gesture out of sync, and lack of focus. And we needed to have perfect focus, or we would be in danger.
That sounds horrible.
It may seem that way sometimes, but it was the best thing for me. I was given the opportunity to develop my skills, to learn. And there was joy in life at the Circle. The joys of fellowship, in knowing that you were not alone in your struggles. In spite of everything, I was happy in the tower, and I loved it.
That's it. Let's see.
Is there something you need?
Nope.
I will answer to the best of my ability.
Never mind. Alright, that's it. Alright, when's done? I'm gonna hold off on talking to Liliana. I have a reason for doing so. I'm not going to be talking to her here for a while, I'm sorry. I love talking to her. It's actually really hard for me not to, but I'm just going to hold off for a little while. Sten.
Yes.
I have a question.
I am hardly surprised.
Never mind.
Very well.
Something you mentioned.
Speak, then.
You said something earlier about mages?
We have no mages such as you do. We have beasts in the shape of men who perform tricks.
Magic is more than tricks.
True. I suppose it is also horror and perversion.
It's not entirely evil, you know.
As a fish stranded by the tide knows the air, or a drowning man knows the sea, so does a mage know magic.
Everything's dangerous in excess.
Can you have just a little drowning? Some things come only in excess. Shera, Are we going to fight the darkspawn or chatter until they grow bored and leave?
Another question.
Very well.
What do you mean your mages are beasts?
I misspoke. They are not beasts. Beasts learn eventually.
What's so terrible about magic?
Mages? Is there some reason you insist upon discussing this?
Trying to figure you out.
I applaud your attempt to pursue knowledge, irritating as it may be.
Thanks.
Can we move on?
Another question.
Very well.
That's enough.
Then I suggest we move on.
Let's go.
I am hardly surprised.
Oh, wrong button. What were you quoting earlier? Hey.
The Kyun. The path to wisdom. I am not surprised you don't recognize it.
What is the Kyun exactly?
Ask a Tamasran. They know how to explain things to children. It is not for me to teach the Kyun.
Something you mentioned?
Speak then.
That's enough.
Then I suggest we move on.
Question?
I am hardly surprised.
Never mind.
Very well.
Let's go.
As you wish.
Wow, he approves plus 11. Click.
Yes.
Question?
I am hardly surprised.
Never mind.
Very well.
Something mentioned.
Speak then.
That's enough.
Then I suggest we move on.
Let's go.
As you wish.
I'm done talking to Sten for now. Wow, plus 11 in that. He's starting to like me, I think. Oh, I have something for you, Morgan. Let's see if you have anything to say first.
I have a thought.
Just the one?
Such wit. Truly, you and Mother should form a troupe of jesters and tour the countryside. We have an opportunity that I believe we should take advantage of. To the point. My mother was once divested of a particular grimoire by a most annoying Templar hunter. It occurred long before I was born, but even today, Flemeth speaks of the loss with great rage. With the Circle of Magi in such disarray, it occurs to me that this might be the perfect time to recover the tome from their possession, for surely it eventually ended up in their hands.
I think I already have it.
What is this? The grimoire? Ever since we discovered the condition of the Mage's Tower, I had wondered if it might be recoverable, but I had yet to speak of it to you. How fortunate that you found it on your own. You have my thanks. I will begin study of the tome immediately.
You're welcome.
I do not intend to squander this opportunity to learn more than Flemeth wished me to know. This should be interesting.
Yay, Morgan approves.
I await your command.
I see something.
So, full of questions, are you?
Never mind. Okay, Morgan's done for now. Excuse me. Talk to Sten, talk to Morgan. Did I speak with Alistair? Don't think I did.
Yes.
Yeah, I did. Never mind. I will try and do one more thing with him. Shall I say that for after Red Cliff? Zevran?
What say you?
You stare at everyone like that?
Not everyone, but a beautiful woman like yourself. Why not? I'm sure you draw many stares from men and even other women. Does this bother you?
Not really. I mean, it's fine. Whatever.
But you would prefer I desisted, perhaps. It would be difficult traveling as we do in close proximity, but I am nothing if not a gentleman.
No, it's fine. No reason for you to have to stop.
Then I shall keep that in mind. And perhaps even read
no,
my efforts.
No,
there was
no,
a young elven dancer in Antiva City once, and I believe I actually managed to stare off all seven of her skirts. It's a trick worth retrying. Now that that is out of the way, perhaps we should move on. With you in front, of course.
Oh, Zevran.
Hmm?
Questions?
All right, but I get to stare at you luridly while you do so.
Tell me about your adventures.
My adventures? I'm hardly an old man just returned from across the ocean, am I? Should I shake my fist at nearby children while I talk about the good old days?
Certainly talk like you've had adventures.
Falling down a flight of stairs is an adventure. Falling into someone's bed, also an adventure. I am assuming what you're looking for are professional anecdotes. Let's see, my second mission ever for the Crows was a bit intriguing. I was sent to kill a mage who had been meddling in politics.
Meddling in politics? How?
How should I know? I got the impression it involved sex, but then I get that impression about most everything. Odd, really.
Zevran.
As it turned out, the mage in question was quite a delightful young woman. Long, divine legs, as I recall. I caught her in a carriage on her way to escape to the provinces. After I killed her...